Welcome to Headlines Nigeria on Internet Television International ITI. My name is Rachel Owa with summaries of news, politics, business and sport from Nigerian dailies. From Vanguard newspaper, policeman mothers taxi driver in Anambra over 20 naira. A mobile police officer at a checkpoint in the commercial town of Onitsha in Anambra State, who killed a taxi driver yesterday for allegedly refusing to offer him 20 naira, is to be dismissed and charged to court for murder. Police public relations officer in Anambra State, Mr. Emeka Chukwu Emeka, who confirmed the incident, said the police officer had been arrested and was being detained at the state police headquarters in Akwa. Cop kills student, commercial driver over 40 naira in Enugu. Normal business activities were paralyzed in some parts of Enugu State capital yesterday as angry members of the National Union of Road Transport Workers, Enugu branch, defied the early morning rain to protest the killing of their member and a secondary school student by the police in Enugu. The incident occurred when a police officer, whose identity was not ascertained at press time, reportedly demanded for 40 naira bribe from the bus driver, but the driver only agreed to part with 20 naira. Alarming level of indiscipline in police worries Onovo. The Inspector General of Police, Mr. Ogbonna Onovo, has said in Akwa Ibom State that there is an alarming level of indiscipline and insubordination in the Nigerian police force, warning that such untoward attitude will no longer be tolerated. I can't be bought over, Jega. The chairman-designate of the Independent National Electoral Commission, INEC, Professor Atahiru Jega, yesterday told the Senate that judging from the assurances he received from the presidency when he was nominated for the appointment, he did not envisage any interference in the discharge of his duties. Commence voters registration now, NOA tax INEC. Registration of voters for the 2011 general elections must commence now if the Independent National Electoral Commission, INEC, is indeed poised towards ensuring a free, fair and credible election, the National Orientation Agency, NOA, has said. From Punch newspaper, house crisis deepens, suspended members' offices sealed. The crisis in the House of Representatives has deepened as the offices of 11 members suspended on Tuesday have been sealed. The doors to the offices were crossed with two white tapes in the style usually adopted by security agents when sealing off a crime scene. On the two tapes was an inscription boldly written, sealed. Alleged 30 billion naira scam, EFCC re-arrests Ogun Diji, four directors. The Economic and Financial Crimes Commission has re-arrested the Ogun State Director General of Bureau of Land and Survey, Mr. Gbenga Ogunoike, and four directors of the Bureau over alleged diversion of 30 billion naira. And in politics, Daily Trust newspaper has this caption, Anti-Bankole rep charged with assault. One of the 11 members suspended from the House of Representatives on Tuesday after they accused the Speaker of corruption has been charged to court for conspiring with others to injure a lawmaker. Austin Nwachukwu, a member of the self-styled group of progressive that caused commotion in the House chamber on Tuesday to stall proceedings on the suspension, was arraigned before a chief magistrate court in Wuse Zone 6, Abuja. From Delhi Independent, I won't step down for Jonathan, IBB vows. Ibrahim Babangida, who ruled Nigeria as a military dictator for 8 years from 1985 to 1993, on Wednesday vowed not to step down for President Goodluck Jonathan in the vote next year, even though Jonathan's run is still speculative. From Punch newspaper, rogues have taken over Nigeria's electoral process, Soyinka SNG. Nobel laureate Professor Wole Soyinka on Wednesday said that rogues had taken over the country's electoral process and denied Nigerians their right to choose their leaders in free and fair elections. 2011, AC member dismisses IBB's presidential ambition. A House of Representatives aspirant on the platform of the Action Congress in Lagos State, Mr. Niyi Rahim, has said that it is obvious that Nigerians are opposed to former military president Ibrahim Babangida's presidential ambition. The aspirant who spoke in an interview also blamed politicians and electoral officials for violence that erupts during elections. 2011, PDP chieftain berates IBB Atiku over zoning. A member of the South-South Elders Forum, Chief Richard Lemai, has berated former military president and ex-vice president Atiku Abubakar for insisting on the zoning arrangement for elective posts in 2011. He said that Babangida and Atiku were spearheading the zoning arrangement to stop Jonathan from contesting the election. And in business, Business Day newspaper, lawmakers' jumbo pay not in line with economic realities. The jumbo salary approved by lawmakers for themselves is not in line with the economic realities in the economy, and their input to the political economy cannot justify the huge pay increase, analysts have said. Under the new National Assembly salary structure, senators' total salary will be 3.24 billion naira, while House of Representative members earn 8.6 billion naira. Senators receive allowances of 26.160 billion naira and 64.8 billion naira for House of Representatives members. The belief is that because the services do not contribute directly to the economy, the huge salary could trigger inflation, especially as the money provided on the various heads in the 2010 budget is part of the reasons for the 5 billion naira deficit. Stakeholders to recover lost investment as Senate passes harmonized AMC. Stakeholders formerly relegated to the background in preference for saving depositors' fund will soon recover their lost investment as the Senate yesterday finally passed the Harmonized Asset Management Corporation Bill, AMCON. Need to harmonize business regulations to achieve Vision 2020. Nigeria is ranked 125 out of 183 world economies in doing business ranking. Last week, at the presentation of the report, the World Bank Country Director on Role emphasized the need for Nigeria to improve in the areas of business regulation if it must achieve its Vision 2020 targets. From Punch newspaper, Jonathan to address G20 business leaders. President Goodluck Jonathan is to deliver a keynote address today in Ontario, Canada, at the opening of the G20 business leaders partnering with Africa's dynamic market. As part of his visit, Jonathan is billed to hold bilateral talks with the Canadian Prime Minister, Mr. Stephen Harper, and thereafter meet with the Canadian business community. Kidnapping. Industrialists lament exodus of investors from Southeast. A prominent industrialist and one of the leading investors in the Nnewi industrial cluster has lamented the damage that insecurity is doing to the economy of the Southeast states. He also said that the federal government must create employment opportunities for young people by reactivating dead industries and making credit facilities available for people willing to set up industries. And in sports, kickoff.com, minister reports NFF to FIFA. Nigeria's sports minister, Isabio, on Wednesday led a delegation that included former Super Eagles captain Austin Okocha to FIFA president Sepp Blatter to ask him to stop elections into the Nigeria Federation from going ahead. Bio's delegation, which also included director of sports Patrick Ekeji and Nigerian ambassador to South Africa Buba Marwa, also accused the NFF of corruption and asked FIFA to step in. From Punch newspaper, government to disband Eagles. The Super Eagles squad that crashed out of the ongoing World Cup in South Africa will be disbanded any moment from now. According to sources, some of the big names will be sent parking, while only the young and dedicated ones will be retained. I don't want Eagles job, Kanu. Super Eagles captain Nwankwo Kanu has denied he is interested in a role in the national team. Kanu, whose effort could not yield Nigeria dividends of the team, crashed out of the ongoing World Cup after a 2-2 draw with South Korea on Tuesday. NFF apologizes to Nigerians. The Nigeria Football Federation has apologized to Nigerians for the Super Eagles' dismal performance at the World Cup. The NFF president, Sani Lulu, said on Wednesday that the body was disappointed that the team could not progress beyond the group stage of the tournament. That's it on this edition of Headlines Nigeria. Thanks for logging on.